Now, on Cape Cantarella, I've been not Réada, on Tara Hirahor, August and Tirahor, Igandara Hui. Réada stood for election for the first time about a year and a half ago in the local elections of May 2014. And not only did she got elected, but she also got elected in the first count. She was over the boat as she was home for her tea by about 11:30 in the day. So she put in a fantastic campaign with Mick O'Reilly's help and plenty of others, but she put in a fantastic campaign. And she went into the council then as our team leader, and she's had a fantastic 2 years for the party. She's, I suppose, a lot of the reason why our poll numbers will be higher here than one might expect, because she's making sure we punch well above our weight. So on Féidir le Faide Award occur Riv Réada Cronin Award.
I was not home for my tea. I stayed 2 days. I missed a whole communion to wait until we all came home. Isn't Cathy Milfogelum, Cathy Milfogel, Hordelum, Machlan, Agus Major Hin Fein, Gurumil Machagot, Vedlum, Anot. This time, 100 years ago, our foreparents, people like us, had a vision for Ireland. Politically progressive activists were working together and daring to dream of an Ireland that worked for her country. They took their inspiration from the Fenians, the United Irishman, the United Irishmen, should I say, and women, and the Kildare man, Theobald Wolfe Tone. Their inspiration found a voice in the Proclamation, a document so ahead of its time that it still remains an aspiration for all of us who love our country. The Irish Proclamation references our desire for sovereignty, liberty, equal rights and opportunities, and unashamedly our happiness and our prosperity. But most of all, it references not just a self-confidence, that false self-confidence that perhaps fuels the Celtic Tiger, but a self-esteem and a belief in ourselves as a nation. While Fine Gael and the Labour Party and Fianna Fáil are worried that the Irish citizens might demand the Ireland that was promised to us 100 years ago, we in Sinn Féin are counting on it. This centenary year is a very, very special year for us. While inclusivity seems to be the buzzword around the 1916 commemorations, the idea, although somewhat askew in my opinion, their idea of it, really inclusivity was never off the Republican table. This is Kildare, where the first Republican uprising against the Crown forces occurred in Prosperous, where rich and poor, Catholic and Protestant, men and women united under the banner of the United Irish Men. We are the aspirant custodians of Tone's Republic, and our duty as Republicans has always been to be oblivious to the differences carefully fostered by an alien government and continued by the counter-revolutionaries in Fianna Fáil, Fine Gael, and the failed six-county Irish state. Uniting communities, uniting our society, and uniting Ireland is the prototype of every Irish Republican. While vision, dreams and aspirations are what drives us, we weren't just born with the proverbial wishbone. We have a very strong backbone in Sinn Féin to deliver our Republic too. This is the stuff that fills our hearts and pumps the blood around our Republican bodies. But if the defenders of the status quo think that this is all there is to us, they haven't got the measure of Sinn Féin at all. This is a very exciting time in politics. Sinn Féin is the biggest party on the island of Ireland, and people are at last turning away from what might have been their parents' party political of choice and looking to us and putting their faith in us to deliver a fair recovery, a fair economy and establish the Republic. No doubt the vested interests will do their worst for the next 2 months on us, but let them at it. Their influence is clearly waning, and who believes them anymore? It might even work, I was saying to Alva earlier, it might even work in getting our vote out this time. They might try to pretend they're doing us a favour by telling us to change our leader. And while we are a party of leaders, and we have a very good potential one here tonight in Mary Lou. Yay! We're not foolish enough to allow our agenda be written by sycophants who'd sell their granny for the smell of a brown envelope. Our leadership leads by example. steer Irish republicanism on the road to peace, a peace with justice at its core. We are standing four square as members of Sinn Féin, well aware of what has to be done to heal our country and unite our country. Aoife spoke the other night about the children of Thatcher and the neoliberal agenda. Her love child, There Is No Alternative, also known as Tina, walks the corridors of power and is the favourite child of those who try to set the narrative. I think that those that sell the Tina line haven't quite understood the groundswell of anger there is against the political classes and the citizen. They expect us to believe that the same people that got us into this mess are the same ones that are going to get us out of them. Well, I don't believe them, and it's our duty as Republicans to make sure that nobody in Kildare believes them either. Since we got five councillors elected in the local elections in May 2014, our support has grown. I'd like to thank my fellow councillors, Aoife, Sorica, Tom and Mark, and indeed Patricia Ryan. I love working with them, and we have made a difference. Not always welcome by the defenders of the establishment in what is a very, very conservative council in Kildare. We've made that difference by bringing our Republican politics into the centre of every motion we bring to Kildare County Council and into every decision and vote we take. We have found our voice in North Kildare, and because of the strength of that voice, it is not unreasonable for us to be looking for a seat in Leinster House. I'd like to thank everybody who's been out traipsing the streets with me so far. I'd like to thank my cumann, the Rose, Ruth Hackett cumann, the Tom Keeley cumann in Selbridge Leixlip, and the Wolf Tone cumann here in Naas. There is no way we would be able to deliver this seat without your help and the cohesion and the efforts that we have put into this. We're going to need to get ones, twos, threes and fours from Leixlip down to Naas, over to Carberry and up to Johnstown Bridge, and in every ballot box in between. And I couldn't even attempt that without your help. The people we represent deserve a TD in Leinster House, and it's our duty to deliver that. Kildare North is a four-seater constituency, with three out of that four currently sitting in government and completely neglecting this constituency. All they've delivered is broken promises and attacks on the family home and the daylight robbery that is Irish water in a country that is currently drowning in it. We've cut our ambulance health service in North Kildare, waiting lists in our hospitals, sick children and elderly being denied medical cards. Fine Gael and the Labour Party are happy to stand over a health system where patients have no dignity and where nurses end their shift in tears. Their only honest attempt to deliver a one-tier health system would be that we would all pay for private health care. What Sinn Féin promise in our health document isn't a harebrained idea about some kind of utopia. It's what every functioning state delivers to its citizens as the norm. Kildare, we have the lowest population of poor across the state, and despite our growing population, it's one of only two counties in the state with no community Gortha. We deserve a people's force which delivers community policing at its heart and not the target-driven political style policing that is the preferred option of the so-called Law and Order Party. Kildare has almost 7,000 families on the housing list, and not one local authority home has been built on this government's watch. Their 11th hour capital spend announcement came too late, and it was too little and too late for the 1,500 children that spent this Christmas homeless. I hope to God that the pittance they're giving to the low paid and the multiples of that they're giving to the higher earners isn't enough to get them off the hook. The Irish people cannot allow our vote to be bought for a quick fumble in the greasy till if they have to walk across the backs of 1,500 children to collect, because that's what it boils down to. And I hope that the Irish people have not become that heartless. Austerity has changed everything. It's affected every generation. We have grandparents Skyping their children across the globe. Children that this country invested in, children that this country educated, children that this country should have cherished. They talk about tough decisions, but no one will convince us that the only decision that Fine Gael found difficult was to restore the Respite Carers grant after being forced in every council across this state by Sinn Féin councillors to make sure that that happened. The truth of the matter is that Fine Gael the Labour Party and Fianna Fáil have no ambition for Ireland. They're happy to wait their turn in the wings, allowing the other their go at the smash and grab politics that has been the order of the day since they took power. They govern like children whose teacher has left the classroom. It is Fine Gael, the Labour Party and Fianna Fáil who are truly unfit for government.
Here, here.
Citizens in Kildare have a choice to make this general election. Are they going to allow themselves to be bought again by smash and grab politicians, the envelope brigade, the cronyism, the corruption, the looking after their friends in high places at the expenses of the ordinary citizen, or are they going to take this opportunity for real change? We have a right to change. We can vote for a Fine Gael-led government that is answerable to no one except the electorate. I am calling on the people of North Kildare to reject the May Fein politics and to vote number one Sinn Féin. It is a privilege for us to represent the only party that has stayed true to the ideals of Pádraig na hÉireann, and I want to deliver a Republican seat for North Kildare. We have a hill to climb in Corja, but others have prepared a path for us, including our own Mick Hall, who we miss very much. Thanks to their efforts, we can be forgiven if we can feel a slight wind at our backs. But nonetheless, there is nobody I would prefer to climb this hill with than ye, my Republican family. It's more an honour done, a scurrimil mahagiv. The Irish Emperor, thank you.